Hi everyone, it's Alyssa and welcome to You Can Learn Math. Today is about distance, the distance formula. This is the the horrible thing that when you first see it in your math book, it kind of makes you die a little inside, because it's that kind of thing where it's, if two trains start 570 miles apart from each other, and one is going 110 miles per hour, and the other is going 120 miles per hour, at what point will they collide in a horrible fiery explosion? And your eyes just glaze over. That's what we're doing! Yay! So, I'm going to take you through three pretty common types of this problem, the three I think you're most likely to see, and might even throw in a bonus of this pretty crazy one that I got from a student this past week, actually, one of my tutoring students that they had. If we have time, we'll see. Keep your hopes up, you might get four of these. So anyway, distance equals rate times time. That's what all of this is going to be based on. That's it. This, when you look at it, okay, that doesn't look too complicated, right? Distance equals rate times time. And we already kind of know this. If I want to know how far my distance, how far I travel, if I'm going, say, 65 miles per hour in a car, and I go for 2 hours, yeah, okay, 65 times 2, that's how many miles. Interesting little thing here. Well, I think it's interesting. Hope you agree. If not, sorry, you're stuck. Just kidding. All right, so miles per hour, you could say miles per hour. That's another way you could write that. And if you're multiplying by hours, those would cancel, and you'd be left with miles. Hey! See, it all makes sense. Wasn't that a lovely little detour? All right, so now distance equals rate times time. That is our overriding one. So here's our first problem. I have two cars that are leaving a central location. They are leaving at 10 a.m. One travels due east, going 50 miles per hour. The other one goes due west. Why are these lines so thin? There we go. And they are going, they're crawling along at 30 miles per hour. After how many hours are they 280 miles apart? I'm so trying not to hiccup in your ear. I get the hiccups so often when I'm talking like this for extended periods of time. I'm sure there's a scientific reason for that, but anyway. Okay, so cars, they're driving directly opposite each other on this magically straight road that has no bends and turns. And one's going a speed, and the other's going like crawling like a snail. So no judgment if you like to travel 30 miles per hour, you do you. After how long are they 280 miles apart? All right, so distance equals rate times time. A method that I've used that I find works pretty well to kind of organize everything is I do a little chart. I say, okay, distance equals rate times time. And then I've got my car, my first car, and I've got my second car. And I'm going to fill everything in. So, okay, the distance, we don't know. We don't know what portion of this 280 miles they each drove. So we're going to leave that alone for now. We're going to fill in what's given, the exact thing that's given in these, and you'll see where we're headed. Because you're like, well, the distance is 280 miles, but I don't know what the first car's distance is. It didn't drive a full 280 miles. Both of them together drove 280 miles. So I don't want to fill that in just yet, because I don't know. I don't know what portion each of them drove. We'll get there. Okay, I do know their rates. The first car, which I'm going to write, and you know what? I'm going to write second in red. So I'm sorry, second in blue. So it'll be really clear which one we're talking about. All right. So the car on the right going east at 50 miles per hour, that is its rate, 50 miles per hour. And I'm not writing miles per hour just to keep my little chart clean, but you know, that's what I mean. Okay. And my second car, the one going west, is going 30 miles per hour. Okay. What is the time? I don't know. I don't know what the time is. So time is going to be our variable that we're trying to find out. Now the time for both of them is the same because they both start at 10 a.m. and then they don't stop for potty breaks. They don't stop at the QT or whatever local gas station you guys have where you live. Where I live, it's the QT. So, you know, they're not stopping at a gas station. They're not stopping for food or, you know, anything. They're just getting in their cars and driving. And then after a certain amount of time, someone calls both of them and says, stop. I'm now calling you to tell you you're 280 miles apart because that's what I do with my life. So that time they've traveled is the same. Well, we know distance equals rate times time. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to multiply these. Yeah, blue. There we go. So rate times time, 50 times t is 50t. 30 times t, and I realize now I wrote that in red. Sorry about that. 30 times t is 30t. So that's their distance. Their distance is 50t and 30t. Now, altogether, their total distance was 280. So I can say 50t plus 30t equals 280. Now that's an equation I can solve, and pretty easily too. 50t plus 30t is 80t. And then 80 times t, to undo that, I'm going to divide by 80. And 280 divided by 80 is 3.5. Okay, so 3.5 hours. That's how long. Well, so at what time are they 280 miles apart? Well, it says they start at 10 a.m. So I go forward 3.5 hours from 10 a.m. And don't be afraid to use your fingers to count on this. Honestly, when you're dealing with time, just go like, okay, 1 hour to 11, 2 hours to 12, 3 hours to one. At 1:30 p.m., they will be 280 miles apart. Okay. Sorry. sorry. Shame on me for not turning my phone off. Sorry about that. Okay. So, a second one right here. All right. Here's another one that they'll give you. They will give you, all right. So now we have two cars that are starting from the same point. The first car, the previous one, remember, they started at the same time. This one, they're starting at the same point, but they're leaving at different times. So I'm going to say the first one starts at 8 a.m. Okay, and leaves going 50 miles per hour. The second car starts 1 hour later. And it's trying to catch up, and it's going 65 miles per hour. At what time does he catch up? Okay, same sort of thing. Distance equals rate times time. I'm going to fill in what I know. My first one, do I know the rate? Yes, I do. The rate is 50 miles per hour. Rate of my second one, what is it? It is in blue. 65 miles per hour. Now, the time for these two is not the same. I'm going to use t to represent the time that the first car, the 50 mile per hour car, the time that it drove. Now, assuming again, they don't stop, they don't take potty breaks, they don't stop for any reason. The 50 mile per hour car drove t hours. How many hours does the 65 mile per hour car drive before it catches up? T minus one. It leaves 1 hour later, so their driving time is 1 hour less. Same thing, I'm going to multiply. 50 times t is 50t. 65 times t minus one, you do it like you distribute it. 65 times t is 65t. 65 times negative 1, negative 65. Now, by the time they catch up, because they're driving in the same direction, they're both driving the same distance. They come at that same point. They come and meet each other at that same point. So we can set the distances equal to each other. That's the difference on this one. We're not adding to anything. We're setting them equal to each other because they're driving the same distance. Okay, so I'm going to solve this. I'm going to subtract 65t from both sides. And I get negative 15t equals negative 65. I divide both sides by negative 15. T equals 4 1/3. If I'm talking about time, 1/3 of an hour, so it's 4 hours and 20 minutes. If they leave, see back up here, they leave at 8 a.m., 4 hours and 20 minutes. They're going to meet at 12:20 p.m. And it didn't register there. It's not registering. There we go, finally. It doesn't like my rainbow pen sometimes. I don't know why. It has issues. At 12:20 p.m. Okay, here's another example for you. Clear this off. All right, third example. Okay, so our third problem is going to be a little different, just to show you sometimes the variable they're asking for, the thing they're asking for can change. Let's say I had two cars starting at two different cities and they're driving towards each other. And the first one is going 45 miles per hour. And our other one is going 55 miles per hour. Okay, so after 2 hours, they pass each other because they're on a normal road. They don't have a collision. They just start going along their merry way and they pass each other. And there's that point where they whoom, go past each other. And it takes it 2 hours. How far apart are the two cities? Well, we can still use our same distance equals rate times time. Some of you who, you know, really kind of like, oh, okay, I'm getting this. You may think, well, I don't need to write this out. It's still a good habit to get into. You're less likely to make mistakes. Okay. So in any event, we're just going to write everything out. So our rate for the first car is 45 miles per hour. The rate for our second is 55. The time is 2 hours for both of them. I've had some students say, well, that doesn't make sense. If this one's going at that speed and they're going these different things, it's 2 hours, same time. And I said, yes, it is, because, you know, they both left at 10 a.m. Let's say they both left at 10 a.m. They started driving towards each other. No one stopped for a bathroom. No one stopped for any reason. They just got in the cars and they drove and they passed each other at 12. They've both been driving for 2 hours. They've gone different distances, but they've both driven for 2 hours. So I just multiply those together. 45 times 2 is 90, so 90 miles. 55 times 2 is 110. And then all I have to do is add those together. 90 plus 110. The cities are 200 miles apart. Okay, now this still would have worked if it had been similar to some of those other problems we did where they don't tell us the time and instead they tell us the distance. So let's say they said, these cities are, come on, there it goes. These cities are 200 miles apart. How long does it take before the cars pass each other? And they might even say, they leave the cities at 10 a.m. precisely. At what time do they pass each other? Okay. Same thing. The one thing I want to reiterate with this, some people, they go, oh, distance, it's 200 miles. And they just write that down. And that will throw you off. You'll get it wrong. Don't do that. Because they're not traveling 200 miles. They're each traveling a portion of the 200 miles. Together, it's 200 miles, but not individually. So if I start writing 200 for both of them, no, we don't want to do that. Okay, so our rates are 45 and 55. Okay. The time, we don't know. That's our unknown. But we know it's the same for both of them. So it's just t for both of them. Okay. And same sort of thing. We're going to say rate times time. 45 times t equals the distance. 45t. This one, rate times time, 55 times t is the distance, 55t. Together, these distances equal 200. So 45t plus 55t is 100t. That equals 200. And I divide both sides by 100. And t equals to 2 hours. They leave at 10 a.m. They pass each other at noon. Okay, so I know I mentioned a bonus problem, but this has gone on, I think I'm going to like about 15 minutes. It's going to be too long. So I'm going to split this up. This is a part one. Part two, the bonus problem, that's the one you're going to go to if you are dealing with a distance rate time problem that has things like, I have a boat in a current and the current is pushing it faster or slowing it down in opposite directions. Or if you have a plane that, okay, in one direction it's going with the wind, other it's going against the wind. A problem that includes that type of thing is in the second part. Okay, so link to that is in the description below. So please click on that if that's the type of distance rate problem you have, because that takes some explanation. That in itself is like 10 to 15 minutes to go through and thoroughly explain everything that's going on with that. All right, so keep an eye out for that. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you so much for stopping by. Hope you have a great day. Bye-bye.